गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेशन 6 ऑफ कोर्स एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन मॉड्यूल 2 वेयर इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी विल स्टडी एडवांसेस इन एनर्जी सिस्टम्स एंड इन सेकेंड पार्ट natural resource management. Before we begin the energy systems advancements in them, let us try to know the sources of energy. We have two types of resources. One is renewable and non-renewable resources. A natural resource is anything that we take from the environment to meet our needs. Solar energy, water, plants, petroleum and minerals are examples. Some resources like water can be used straight away, while others like petroleum need some processing before use. A renewable resource is one that nature replenishes again and again over time through its own processes. One example is fresh water, which we get as rain every season. Clean air, fresh topsoil, forests and fish are other examples of renewable resources. A non-renewable natural resource is available as a finite amount on Earth and does not replenish itself over human time scale. Petroleum, coal, minerals are examples. They were formed over millions or billions of years, but we have been depleting them rapidly over the last 2 centuries. As a result, we will exhaust such resources at some time or other. If we use them carefully, they would be available to us for a long time to come. So we have found advancements in energy systems as a solution to these problems. We have various energy systems such as hydrogen energy system, solar energy system, OTEC, that is ocean thermal energy system, wind energy system, etc. So today we are going to take up the hydrogen energy system. It is a sustainable and clean energy. It is becoming clear that hydrogen and fuel cell technology present a considerable part of the solution to our energy needs. Hydrogen functions as a universal energy carrier, that is, converted to energy in fuel cells with water as the only emission. Hydrogen is produced from water using renewable energy sources. This energy system therefore holds the potential of zero emission. The renewable energy is stored in hydrogen by splitting water into hydrogen and oxygen by use of electricity. This process is called electrolysis. In this slide, the first picture shows the reaction between hydrogen and oxygen, where water will be the product of this reaction. Due to reaction between hydrogen and oxygen, here we will get the energy. And the second picture in this slide shows the conceptual energy system using water electrolysis to produce hydrogen, which is used as fuel, gas, or an energy storage medium. Here, water electrolysis produces hydrogen and it is fed into the fuel cell, where reaction between hydrogen and oxygen takes place inside the cell and energy is obtained as a product, where water is obtained as an emission and the energy obtained is sent to the electric grid. So this is how the fuel cell works. The reaction takes place here is reaction between hydrogen and oxygen with water as the only emission. And this is how hydrogen energy system works. We have taken one typical example here where we can use hydrogen to run the cars. And here we will fill the hydrogen, and this is fuel port, and it is sent to hydrogen tanks which provides hydrogen to fuel cells. And also we have battery here and safeguard tanks. Here we have one fuel cell stack, fuel cell where reaction takes place, and an electric motor here which helps to run the or to move the axles, to make the axles rotate. In turn the vehicle moves, and a power control unit on top of the fuel cell. There are also other methods are available for the production of hydrogen. Other production methods will also be used to create hydrogen from fossil fuels. After the production, hydrogen functions as an energy carrier that can be used to supply energy wherever it is needed. A fuel cell is used to convert the hydrogen into energy again. In the fuel cell, hydrogen and oxygen reacts and creates water as the only emission. In a flame of pure hydrogen gas burning in air, the hydrogen reacts with oxygen to form water and releases energy. In this equation, you can understand the process where hydrogen and oxygen reacts to produce energy and water as emission. The energy released enables hydrogen to act as a fuel. The reaction creates electricity and heat that can be used in various applications. Fossil fuels today are the cheapest way to produce hydrogen. Now we have the applications of the hydrogen energy system. This hydrogen energy system has found its application in mobile cell phones, cars, buses, and even as large heat and power plants. Hydrogen fuel can provide motive power for liquid propellant rockets, cars, trains, boats, and aeroplanes. Portable fuel cell applications or stationary fuel cell applications which can power an electric motor. Now let us look into the merits and demerits of this hydrogen energy systems. It's a renewable energy source and bountiful in supply. Numerous sources are available to produce hydrogen locally, and it is practically a clean energy source similar to electric power. No emissions, no carbon dioxide, no nitrogen oxide, etc. And hydrogen energy is non-toxic. The use of hydrogen greatly reduces pollution and it is more efficient than other source of energy, and it is also used for powering spaceships. What are the demerits of hydrogen energy system? Hydrogen fuel is hazardous because of the low ignition energy and high combustion energy of hydrogen, and because it tends to leak easily from tanks. The hydrogen is lighter than air and it is highly risky. The storage of this hydrogen gas is highly risky and very complicated. We have found hydrogen in the first group of periodic table. It is very lighter than oxygen, so it moves in the upward direction in the atmosphere as it is lighter than oxygen. And hydrogen energy is expensive. It is not the safest source of energy, and also transportation of hydrogen is tedious. It's a complicated process due to its lightness. Its separation from oxygen requires other non-renewable resources such as coal, oil and natural gas. Now let us take up the other energy system, that is solar energy system. We get solar power from sunlight, and solar power is the conversion of energy from sunlight into electricity, either directly using photovoltaics or indirectly using concentrated solar power, that is CSP, or a combination. Let us try to understand what is PV and CSP, that is photovoltaic cells and concentrated solar power systems. CSP, that is concentrated solar power systems, use lenses or mirrors and solar tracking systems to focus a large area of sunlight into a small beam. Whereas photovoltaic cells convert light into an electric current using photovoltaic effect. And we have the world's largest solar park in Karnataka in Tumkur district in Pavagada Taluk. This solar park is capable of generating 2050 megawatt. Currently, the largest photovoltaic power station in the world is Pavagada Solar Park, which is located in Karnataka. And this is how the photovoltaic power system works. It converts light into electric current using photovoltaic effect. Here, these solar panels or modules receive the sunlight, and the direct current is obtained, and which is received by inverter, and it converts the direct current into alternate current, which can be used for domestic purposes. Also, this alternate current can be stored in battery whenever there is no power supply in villages or any other area, remote areas. If you are producing excess current, you can send it to, or you can sell it to the other private systems, or you can send it to the grid. Even you can sell the excess energy or excess power generated due to solar modules or solar system, you can sell it to the other government agencies or other private agencies, for which you will be paid. Then let us look into how the CSP system works. The concentrated solar power system uses lenses or mirrors and tracking systems to concentrate sunlight, then use the resulting heat to generate electricity from conventional steam driven turbines. And here are the, we have the few applications of solar energy systems. Since from 1930s, it is used to heat the water, solar water heater facing the sun to maximize the gain. It is one of the application. And in 1939, MIT Solar House, the MIT built a solar house in the US. It is used seasonal thermal energy storage for year-round heating. And parabolic dish, steel dish, produces steam for cooking using sunlight. And this solar power or the heat, solar heat energy is also used for water disinfection. Here we have an example in Indonesia. And in 2007, Darmstadt University of Technology, Germany has won this 2007 solar decathlon in Washington DC with this passive house designed for humid and hot subtropical climate. This solar power has found its application even in agricultural field. You can see here in this picture the greenhouses like this in the Westland municipality of Netherlands grow vegetables, fruits and flowers. And also the solar energy is used to run the vehicles. And we have one more application in aeronautical field, solar electric aircraft, which was made to run in 2015 successfully. And also, concentrated solar panels are getting a power boost. A laboratory, that is Pacific Northwest National Laboratory, has tested a new concentrated solar power system, that is CSP system, one that can help natural gas power plants to reduce their fuel usage by up to 20%. And we have found one more application, thermal energy storage. The Andosol CSP plant uses tanks of molten salt to store solar energy. Now, what are the merits and demerits of the solar energy systems? It is, solar power is pollution free and causes no greenhouse gases, and it reduces the dependency on foreign oil, crude oil or petroleum products, and also it reduces the dependency on fossil fuels, and it is a clean power, and virtually it requires no maintenance as the solar panels last over 30 years. And it also creates jobs by deploying solar panels manufacturers, solar installers, and in turn helps the economy. Excess power can be sold back to the power company if grid is intertied. And we can use batteries to store the extra power for use at night. And it is safer than traditional electric current. The efficiency of solar energy is always improving, so the same size solar that is available today will become more efficient tomorrow. And also it improves the aesthetics of a building when solar panels are installed on a rooftop or any other sloping roofs. And no trenching or digging of earth is required, since the solar can be close to or at the place of installation. Then, demerits of the solar system. It's not the merits, it is demerits. The initial cost is very high. for material and installation, and it needs lot of space as efficiency is not 100% yet. No solar power at night, so there is a need for large battery to store the energy. Devices that run DC power directly are more expensive. And depending on geographical location, the size of solar panels vary for the same power generation. Cloudy days do not produce much energy. Solar panels are not being mass produced due to lack of material and technology to lower the cost enough to be more affordable. Solar powered cars do not have the same speeds and power as typical gas powered cars, or when compared to other combustion engine vehicles. Lower solar production is observed in the winter months. With this, we will end up the session 6, and we will meet in the next session.